صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما حتى تنالوا جنة ونعيما صلوا عليه.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back. We're in the last segment of this very beautiful show where we've been highlighting and giving exposure to Operation Qurbani 2014 under the auspices of South African National Zakah Fund. Before the break, we spoke a little bit about Malawi and Mozambique, where SANZF has been undertaking Operation Qurbani for 22 years. Subhanallah. Over 8,000 animals slaughtered. Inshallah, this will be slaughtered this year and hopefully more animals as the years go on. Master Faraz in our Cape Town studio, let's move the focus now to closer to home, here South Africa, where the South African National Zakah Fund will be undertaking Qurbani. Share with us a little bit about the experience. Early on in the show, we chatted about preparedness and readiness and visiting the different sites, etc. Where to from here with a few weeks, maybe a few days left before Qurbani?
Jazakallah for that. Well, if I were to bring the operation a little closer to home, as we know that the need in South Africa is still great. There are many people that are underprivileged that also require, and that's one of the advantages. I won't say it's the purpose of Qurbani. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you know, that it is for the purpose of gaining taqwa. But the benefits of it is that those that are less fortunate get this privilege. And I think that's where the South African National Zakah Fund uses its network throughout the country to be able to ensure that this kind of need is met within underprivileged or less fortunate communities. So the viewers will be very familiar with the idea that wherever you go, you find a South African National Zakah Fund office, you find one of the offices, whether it's in Joburg, whether it's in Durban, the Western Cape, Ladysmith, East London, Bloemfontein, all these places have, Kimberley, they all have offices that you can contact, that you can go to, that you can ask how you can be more specifically involved in terms of the operation of Qurbani during the Qurbani time. But you know, the programs obviously vary slightly depending on your region, depending on the needs required in that particular region. Alhamdulillah, having been involved in Qurbani last year in the Western Cape, I was extremely privileged to actually go out on the day of Qurbani on the day, and there were many donors who came to the farm who wanted to view the Qurbani, which is something we encourage. We say, if you have the time, why not? And why not come to the farm? Why not view the Qurbani? Why not see this beautiful sunnah of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam happening? And if you can't make it to the farm, you know, be part of the distribution process. Come and be with us on the day on the days that follow, so that you can see how this meet and how your contribution has made a meaningful change in the lives of so many people in the country. So the Operation Qurbani runs differently in various areas in the country. We have what we call the local family Qurbani program, where this is where we encourage the donors to be part with their families to come and view the Qurbani. Then we do the Qurbani that is specifically for distribution. That is what we do. We may not do those at the farms. We do it at either abattoirs, or we do it at other farms that are more outlying, in more outlying areas, to ensure, because there we can work at a quicker rate where we can so that we can distribute the meat on time. And then local Qurbani at Dawah centers. We work with other centers, and sometimes in some parts of the countries we take the animals to a particular area. Not too much, obviously. We've got a restriction that is placed on from animal rights groups and so on and so forth. But we take a few, perform the Qurbani there, and alhamdulillah, just to witness the Qurbani in more locations. So these programs are running throughout the country, and because they vary so much, I would encourage the viewers to please do stay in touch with your local SANZF office, who can give you more insight into the programs as they're having. And what better way to spend our Eid, what better way to spend it than to spend it with the actual sunnah of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah, we spend a lot of time and energy putting in the effort to know who we're visiting, what we're wearing, and so on and so forth. But we need to get back to the essence of Qurbani, and that is to feel the sense and the spirit of sacrifice. And if we are not ready to do it at our homes, because we always encourage people, do your Qurbani yourself. And if you're not able to, the South African National Zakat Fund gives you that facility. So come out, be part of the Qurbani, and see what it is to make the sacrifice and what it's like to
contribute. Of the ayah, لَا يَنَالُ اللَّهَ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا وَلَا كِيَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not in need of the meat or the blood, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala seeks out this righteousness. And one of the unique dimensions of SANZF's Operation Qurbani is the encouragement and the call to all and sundry to be physically part of that operation in terms of witnessing the Qurbani. Part of the SANZF project also being that SANZF takes Operation Qurbani to more sites so that more of the Ummah of Muhammad also may be privy to witnessing the actual act of Qurbani. Another very beautiful thing you mentioned was the idea that if for some reason people cannot make themselves available on the day of slaughtering to be part of the actual slaughter and Qurbani, then they have the opportunity of being part of the distribution. You know, all of these give me a sense of reassurance of knowing that SANZF is not calling for an outsourced Qurbani. Contact us, we'll do Qurbani on your behalf. But SANZF is calling towards the ideal of reliving the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and more importantly, the Sunnah of our patriarch Ibrahim alayhi salam, by being physically part of that project. There's also some new dimensions and initiatives that SANZF has, you know, put in place this year for people to execute their Qurbani. Those who don't have the opportunity or don't have access to any of these regional offices who still want SANZF to undertake Qurbani on their behalf, how can they get involved?
We know that the operation, let me just say, start off by saying that the operation of Qurbani, like Uncle Yusuf Tara said, it doesn't start now. The checking and stuff happens months in advance, right? But the actual launch of Operation Qurbani, which take place towards the end of this month, right, at the end of the end of August, we find that we launch it. So you'll see the posters, you'll see the pamphlets, you'll see the street signs and so on and so forth go up, and you will have an opportunity to engage. If you've forgotten, it's an opportunity for you to save up. So what I'm saying is, in essence, we have some time between now and the day of Eid to get to a SANZF office. And if we can't get to the SANZF office, our banking details are very clear on our website. People can always contact us. And sometimes, you know, what we realize is that yes, you may be available on Eid day, or you may be available on the day to distribute with us, but you're finding it so difficult between the hectic work schedules and the kids and so on and so forth that you may not be able to come out to a SANZF office during this month, or you leave it. And we know sometimes we leave things till the last. So what we've done is we've made sure that the facility is available on our website as well. Anybody can go to www.sanzf.org.za, that's the website, and you can do an online donation. Choose Qurbani, choose where you'd like it to be done, and at a very affordable price, alhamdulillah, you can have your Qurbani, you can order the Qurbani, you can have your Qurbani done, do your niyyah form and all those kinds of things, so that come the day of Eid, you can rest assured that you can either come to a SANZF, SANZF location, or you can, or if you can't make it on the day of Eid, then the days that follow to come and witness and be part of the distribution. But it is all available. We're trying to make it, you know, without taking away that essence of sacrifice, without taking away the spirit that should be around the time, we've tried to make it as easy as possible for our donors to so that there's no excuse. We cannot possibly say that we cannot do Qurbani. If we are able to afford it, then we know that it is something that we should do in some madhahib, in sometimes wajib, sometimes sunnah, whatever the case is, it is something that we need to do. I mean, I just want to say at this juncture that we could go to a butcher and we could purchase a kilo of meat or 2 kilos of meat or 5 kilos of meat and want to give it out to those less fortunate. I don't think that is the purpose of sacrifice. Every ibadah, every aspect of worship has its unique nature. And the unique nature of this act, as we alluded to in the beginning of the show, the uniqueness of this is that we go and we witness that sacrifice that was done. And then we take that sacrifice and we don't just end it there, we take it and we actually translate that into a donation for those less fortunate. We translate that into a meaningful change within the community. And mashallah, how beautiful the deen has given us this opportunity to take an act of ibadah and to not only show its connection and its relationship between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in other words, the state of our hearts, but it takes that exact ibadah and it translates it into a benefit for the community. And while our purpose and our niyyah is for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look how beautifully and mashallah that the community can benefit from this kind of sacrifice.
My last question to you, if someone doesn't have the opportunity or doesn't have the wealth to be able to undertake qurbani this year, but has a firm resolve and niyyah that inshallah by next year they would like to save up for qurbani, does SANZAF have any system in place that allows someone to contribute perhaps on a monthly timeline towards a qurbani for not this udhiyah but for the next udhiyah?
Alhamdulillah, yes, we do. It's something that we're also launching this year, alhamdulillah. And thank you for reminding me about that, because it's a new initiative, mashallah, where we're giving donors an opportunity. We're saying, look, you know, the cost just escalates year on and year. Alhamdulillah, this year we've tried to keep it the same. But, you know, not everybody can afford 1,500 rand or 1,300, whatever the place, the cost is in a particular region. Not everybody can afford it. So we're saying, you know, let's not make the spirit of sacrifice or the intention or the niyyah only start at the time when you hear SANZAF on radio, when you see SANZAF on TV, or when you see SANZAF in the newspapers. Let us have our niyyah now and say, listen, you know what? I've been wanting to do this. I've been wanting to follow the sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam for a long, long time. And I've never had the opportunity either. There's no mechanism in place for me to do this. So what I want to do is, I want to save up. By all means, come to a SANZAF office. We will be able to ensure that we put something in place that will be able to record a monthly contribution on your side, so that by the end of the year, should we say that next year comes and you know, you've saved up 1,500 rand and sheep is 1,000 or qurban is 1,600, it's only a 100 rand difference. But at least then there is a mechanism in place for you to ensure that you would be able to meet that requirement by next year, inshallah.
We're fast running out of time, and we'd like to say jazakumullah khairan to both to Maulana firstly from the Cape Town studios of ITV, as well as Uncle Yusuf Tara Sirat and Uncle Abdul Karim Ghani, for your time and for sharing with our viewership this insight into Operation Qurbani 2014. We hope that every viewer will take the opportunity, inshallah, of undertaking Qurbani and inshallah, hopefully choosing to partner with SANZAF in terms of undertaking this Qurbani. With that, we say Jazakumullah Khairan to all of you and Wassalamu Alaikum wa Rahmatullahi wa Barakatuh. صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما حتى تنالوا جنة ونعيما 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 صلوا عليه.